I want to show you three techniques that can be particularly useful when analyzing multiple response data in IBM SPSS statistics. I call these advanced techniques not because they are especially difficult, rather because they are less obvious solutions that you might not know about without some advanced knowledge of SPSS. The first technique is filling in missing values when you use survey software to collect your data. This is a raw Excel version of a response set from Qualtrics. This format is very similar to what you would get as output from a SurveyMonkey survey as well. This is what many students confront when they use online survey software for a project. In this study, the ethnicity variable gave respondents the option to check all that apply. If they checked the item, it was coded as 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. If they did not check the item, the values are missing. This is system missing data. It is missing because the system did not collect that data. However, we know that this missing data indicates that someone really selected no instead of yes. We actually know what these missing data should have been. In other words, these data are not missing because certain respondents were not asked the question. They are missing because the respondent did not think this option applied to them. We can clean up this missing data by inserting a zero for all missing responses. When doing multiple responses, replacing missing data is less important if all that you need are the frequencies from your check all that apply responses, but replacing missing data can be very important if you want to analyze the data using crosstabs. Here I have imported this raw Excel data into SPSS and done some minor data cleaning, mostly for anonymity. Now I will replace all of those system missing data. Go to Transform, Recode into Same Variables. Move all of the ethnicity variables that have system missing values into the Numeric Variables box. And then click on Old and New Values. Under Old Value, select the range of values, 1 through 6. These will all be recoded as a 1. Now click on System Missing to select all of the system missing values. Under New Values, we will assign a value of 0. Click Continue and OK. This technique will replace all of the missing values with zeros. 1 will be the counted value, so we have 1s and 0s ready to use in our multiple response set. The second technique is useful when you have more than one counted value that you want included in your multiple response set. This is data from the 2016 General Social Survey. For these items, people were asked about the reasons that they attended an art exhibit, and they could check all that applied to them. Look at the item asking about the importance of wanting to experience high-quality art in the decision to attend an art exhibit. The answer options are major reason, minor reason, not a reason, and then all of the missing data codes. We want to consider only whether a given reason was a major reason, a minor reason, or not a reason, excluding all of the other responses. So we want answer options 1, 2, and 3, ignoring all others. Go to Analyze, Multiple Response, Define Variable Set. Find all of the items about importance. and then move them into the variables in set box. Instead of using dichotomies, yes or no, one or zero, we select categories. And our range was responses 1 through 3. We will name our multiple response set attend for reasons that they attended the art exhibit, and then click close to define it. Now go to analyze, multiple response, frequencies. Move the attend response set into the box tables 4. Click OK. In the output, we are given the number of people who provided a response to each item, the percent of responses, and the percent of cases for major reason, minor reason, and no reason. We are focusing on the responses of interest, keeping them separate, and we have ignored all other responses. You might use this technique, for example, if you wanted to consider whether people indicated strongly agree, agree, or neutral on a set of items, rather than considering each item separately. What can we do, however, if we want to consider both major and minor reasons together? The third technique I want to show you is what to do when you have two answers that you want to consider together instead of separately. So for example, we want to know whether a given reason was any kind of reason at all, major or minor. We want to combine both major reason and minor reason into a single category and compare it to all others. For this, we need to combine the data first and then create the variable response set. We will keep using the same GSS 2016 dataset. Go to Transform, Recode into Same Variables. Honestly, a better technique for this would be to recode into different variables so that you can keep both your original variable and the new one. I am recoding into the same variable simply because of the huge number of variables in this dataset, and I don't want to scroll all the way to the bottom to find the new variables that I recode. The importance here is to simply show you the technique. Move all of the variables to be recoded into the numeric variables box. Then, click on Old and New Values. Under Old Value, select 1, major reason, and set the new value to 1. I always do this so that I am sure that I have accounted for all of the answer options. Select 2, which is minor reason, and set the new value to 1. This combines both the major and minor reasons into a single category, coded as 1, that represents that this was a reason of some kind. Depending on your dataset, you may choose to leave the other data as they are, or if you want to set all of the other data to 0, considering that the missing data mean not a reason, click on All Other Values and set the new values to 0. As I said earlier, if you get the frequency table, the output will be exactly the same regardless of what you do with all other values. The only values that SPSS considers are the counted values. On the other hand, if you are going to use crosstabs, setting the other values to 0 will give you a much better cross-tabulation table. These three advanced techniques will give you even more options when using multiple response data in SPSS.